This is a small demonstration showing how to use Baystate Blue, what papers work well with it, what pens are good with it, and why I'm instituting some additions to Baystate Blue. It's this particular 4.5 ounce offering is sold out right now. And I found, given that it's the change of the year, it offers itself as the perfect opportunity to add something to the product. Profit's not a motive with this product. It's more of a passion and a philosophical issue with me that Baystate Blue has become the cutting edge of ink. It's not that it's laser resistant, as was mentioned in the article in The Economist magazine. It's not that the contrast of the blue color is the greatest of any ink sold. But what it does embody in the arguments about it online is a philosophical difference between those who believe the individual consumer should be free to choose whatever ink that happens to bring them pleasure or serves their purposes as an individual without any coercion by a greater group of so-called holier-than-thou experts who believe they're nearer to God than the rest of us mere mortals. I got this book by Milton and Rose Friedman after there was a PBS special in the early 1980s. This book was bought used at a book sale around 1984, and I've read it many times to the point where the binding is a little rough. I highly recommend it, and it's this book that will cause this ink to continue to be made until I'm a dead man, regardless of what anyone says about it online. I will not be herded in by a crowd of so-called holier-than-thous into canceling this ink. And I want to show you why this ink deserves your attention. First of all, if somebody says it takes too long to dry, or they've got issues with it penetrating or feathering or the like, this is a sheet of copy paper. It's 88 brightness, 20 pound weight, 8.5 by 11 inches. It's a ream. This is non-recycled, and it was purchased at Walmart for $1.72 for this whole ream of paper. Baystate Blue doesn't feather on it. It doesn't have any issues on it. And in case somebody says, well, where do you find a pen that writes with Baystate Blue? Well, most pens write with Baystate Blue. I'd like you to observe that in every 4.5 ounce box, there is now, this is the easiest way to extract this pen from the box, is to screw it on in advance. This is a brush pen. And it's eyedropper filling. There has almost always been this particular eyedropper. But there's a little addition now. As of the first of the year, every Baystate Blue comes with this brush pen, comes with this demonstrator eyedropper, and comes with this ink ball attachment. The fountain pen is friction fit. Comes out like that. The ink ball attachment is also friction fit. It's inserted just like that. Take the ink out. Note the blue color. It's one of the, if not the most dramatic blues, even in the vintage line of inks stretching out over the past 100 years. Certainly in modern inks, it is by far the greatest contrast of any blue. You'll note on this model brush pen there is an O-ring here, and this is completely open. The O-ring is tight enough that there'll be resistance as you screw it on. It's slightly lubricated so that it's easy. You'll also note that it took many fillings of the dropper. This is a massive ink supply in this pen. On the side it says push. Squeeze it a little bit a few times. And you'll see the end of the brush gradually getting covered with Baystate Blue. This eyedropper also contains a mammoth quantity of ink. Far more than any cartridge pen. Far more than virtually any self-filler. Just filling it up to the threads. Just like that. Until the O-ring exhibits flattened sides. Don't squeeze it so tight that you push the O-ring out. You just want the O-ring to make a seal. Now I'm tapping it a little bit because with the rollerball unit, there is an air vacuum where there's no capillary action here. It has to establish initial flow beyond that point. Set that aside. The rollerball will take approximately 20 seconds for the ink to go through the felt feeder and to initially reach the ball tip. Okay. This is pretty heavy. You'll note I can make this pretty wet. I'll put make it even wetter. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to put a bead of ink in the brush so that it can make it appear wet with the camera. There, see? Now, what I'd like to show you, perhaps more up close, that was a heavy bead. It was wet. There's no feathering. There's no smearing. Heavy bead of ink, and if it's put flat on the page, you can barely see the other side. There's no bleed through to the other side. And now, this is water here. Now, this is only seconds after I wrote it. Do you see any smearing, streaking, or removal of the ink? See? Try to find a blue that performs this well, with this great a contrast, anywhere in the market. And then ask the naysayers on a certain group what the hell they're smoking. I'll just leave it there for demonstration purposes. Now here's a different type of stationery. It's fountain pen network pad. Bring this closer to the camera. Try to find a roller ball anywhere on the market that is as smooth as this mechanism. Now bear in mind, this is now no pressure. In fact, I'll take the sheet off, extend it in midair, and I'll write the full darkness of the line, nothing underneath it, an extraordinarily smooth mechanism. Now, can put that out. This is the fountain pen. Tap it a little bit to get that initial flow. You're getting that, it's never been used before, so it takes a little while. And once you get beyond that initial 20 seconds, there you are. Just folding the paper out like this. There's nothing underneath it. No table, no support, and it's that smooth, and it's that easy. Both of them are. Now, see that color? Do you see any feathering there? The density? There's no feathering, no issues. Performs as a stupendous ink, and that is the reason so many people like it. This is a second film on Baystate Blue. This is a Noodler's Ebonite pen. Now, the clear sack, most clear sacks in history, are stain prone, and Baystate Blue will stain this sack. This has a flex nib on it. These will be more available as time progresses. Note, this is friction fit. This is a dual filling pen. It can either fill as the aerometric with the breather tube, or it can fill as a as an eyedropper. It has a little O-ring seated right here. It pulls off quite easily. And the breather tube is a little ways from the back. By gently pulling, the sac pulls right off. A little bit of adhesive there. You can leave the breather tube in. It acts as an ink drain when it's upright. Just up to the threads of the inside threads of the barrel. And with this one, because the O-ring is on the inside, you screw it relatively tightly, and you'll see a smooth continuum, like the pen was a streamlined bullet. Okay, see if I can give you a better view of this pen at this angle. This has just been filled with Baystate Blue. It's got a flex nib, it's an ebonite Noodler's pen. And see what we can do here. It's like writing with a metallic brush. It's this extra fine line. I'm trying to do it with a light hand and not remove the pen tip from the page. And then with a little bit of pressure, it's not too much, I'll show you. It's not too much pressure. I'm using it the end of the pen from the hairline. There. Hopefully that's a good enough demonstration of what this flex is capable of. Hairline out to 2 millimeters. Same nib. This bottle here, if you see made in Taxachusetts and a small serial number under the tail of the catfish holding the Massachusetts flag, this bottle is my thank you to you, at least whichever one of you here or there in various countries gets a bottle like this. When you see it, put it in water and just soak it, and just like the Baystate Blue over there, these labels are waterproof and it'll come off as a sheet. Put it on a paper towel, let it dry, and then mail it in to the U.S. distributor or anyone who can get it here. And it is worth $50 of Noodler's fountain pens. And they'll be sent to you direct from the company. The video service only has about 15 minutes. To show you a time lapse, I didn't have enough time to tinker with the software and show you 1 minute duration photos and the like. I'm sort of doing these videos on the fly. These were recently filled with Baystate Blue, and I want to demonstrate to you how they clean up. Some people want to use the free pens that are included with the 4.5 ounce bottle of Baystate Blue with other inks. Before you do that, note right on the side of the bottle tells you never to mix it with another ink. This ink does not get along with others. That common household bleach you apply to the pens, that takes between 5 and 11 minutes and it'll clear them out. You will never get the silicone grease that is in the threads. That will never stop turning blue. The Baystate Blue is protected from the bleach by the silicone, which repels the bleach. So don't get worried if you see some blue-colored silicone in the threads. That's normal, and that doesn't really affect anything anyway. It's still functional silicone, even though it's blue. You'll note there's still a tad bit of blue in the brush, but this brush in this color, you're almost white. This is functional, and the felt feeder. Some of these are borderline cellulose based. Some of them have a cellulose core, and it's more difficult to clean these. So my recommendation is, the company sells these so that they're readily available for about 25 cents. I suggest that you set one aside for your favorite ink, and just use it with that color. It's easy enough to pop them out and replace them. Just buy four or five of them and set them aside. It's 25 cents. It'll save you time. I think it's worth it. But if you want to save the 25 cents, you can separate this, apply a little bleach, and you can then use this with a different color. If this ever clogs because you left it away on vacation, little bit of bleach inside here. This is a bleach-resisting stainless steel. And you see it's just friction fit. The felt feeder goes in here until it's firm. And on this particular pen, it's friction fit in the holder. You push it in until the step in the steel stops, and then your holder is done. And then you're ready to try another color. With the brush pen, this unit is also friction fit. Take the brush, put it back into its feeder. This regulator plug is in back, holds the brush in place. This is then friction fit into the section. Reassemble as before, and you're ready to try another ink. I will show you this piston filler, which Noodler's is carrying. This is a Nib Creeper ink ball. A lot of people noted that this particular grade of plastic behaved very well with Baystate Blue. Note the color. Now notice I didn't I only moved it back and forth once with the piston. Baystate Blue feeds to these very quickly. It's ideally adapted to it. It's absolutely incredibly smooth with this particular pen. Suspending the page in air. Now this is an ink ball. There are a lot of gel pens, ink balls, and ballpoints that cannot write with this little pressure. And yet, if you have a heavy hand, this pen will take it. I made an impression that went straight through the page. So, it's durable in that fashion. And it writes extremely well with this particular ink. Another feature of this ink that customers have written in about, they dilute it. They dilute it quite a bit. Now, when it's not on paper, it dilutes in the water. If you're dedicating the pen to Baystate Blue, this is all that's needed to do occasionally to maintain it. Just rinse it out with tap water. Just now, you're never going to get that silicone lubricant on the piston to clear. That silicone lubricant, this has a minor amount of it. You can see it's clearing up now, with the exception of that narrow piece of silicone lubricant. Silicone protects the ink from the bleach. But you can see it's perfectly clear, and if you are worried about issues of coloration on, in the barrel wall or the like, Noodler's offers this pen. As an answer to that concern, this pen sells for $14. And this is an ink ball with a handmade ebonite feed. And this tip, if you want to dedicate it to Baystate Blue or dedicate it to another color, this tip is 25 cents. Can't make the economics more attractive than that. It's the lowest price on one of these in the world. And before a snob tells you that theirs is better because they simply paid more money for it, there's another word for somebody who pays more money for something and it's no better. I won't use it here. But this 25 cent tip, this is made in Switzerland, and it is basically has the same tolerances as the ones that you pay $35 replacements for. So I think people should do the math, and they shouldn't automatically assume that a product is better simply because it's more expensive.